Hey guys, Vikas over here, and this is We Are Genius. Guys, today I am again with a new video around Linkit Smart 7688 Duo module. We'll see how to program the ATmega324 microcontroller that is present in the module by using Arduino IDE. And we'll be doing it from a host PC. And if you are new to Linkit Smart 7688 Duo module, consider checking my earlier tutorial around it, which is getting started with a Linkit Smart 7688 Duo module, where I have shown how to get started with this and some basic setups about it. If you are aware of Linkit Smart 7688 Duo module, you might be knowing that the module features two controllers, which are the 7688 microprocessor and the ATmega324 with Arduino bootloader. And both controllers' GPIOs are exposed as pins. So in this video, we'll access the ATmega controller from a PC and we'll program it by using Arduino IDE. So being said that, let's get started guys. So guys, to start with this, we'll first add the board support packages for Linkit Smart 7688 module to our Arduino IDE. This is required as Arduino IDE doesn't support the Linkit Smart module by default. To do that, get into preferences, and over here on additional board managers URLs, you just need to add the link that is for the board support packages, and that is from MediaTek Lab. So I'll just provide the link down below in the description. Otherwise, I'll just provide the link to the page of MediaTek Lab from where you can copy this link. So click on OK. Now get into boards manager, and over here you just need to search for Linkit. So I'll just search for Linkit, and you'll see Linkit Smart 7688 Duo by the distribution MediaTek Labs. So I'll just choose the latest version and click on install. This again might take some time, and it is completed. So after installation, you'll see something like remove button appearing over here and the version over here. So you can see other versions are not installed. So that's fine. Let's close it. Now under boards, you'll see let's get into this, the Linkit Smart 7688 module listed. Yep, you can see over here, just select the board, but under ports you'll not find the Linkit COM port, and for that actually we need to install the required drivers for that. And to do that, I'll just connect my Linkit module to the PC and we'll download the required drivers from the MediaTek Lab website. So let's just quickly connect the module to the PC. The module has got two micro USB sockets, and one is actually for MCU and power, and second one acts as an USB host. Connect your micro USB cable to the socket which says MCU power. Now after connecting the Linkit module to the PC, let's download the required drivers. So let's just get into MediaTek website, and over here in the install driver section, copy this link, or you can simply click on that and download the drivers. After that, get into your downloads folder, extract the downloaded file. I have actually already extracted that, that's why it is showing that dialog. Now on this INF file, right click on it and click on install. Select open. Yep, click on install this driver software anyway. Again, all these things are required if you are using Windows. So if you are using like Linux or Mac, these things are not required. They will be auto mounted as serial COM port. Now let's get into computer manage and see if we can find the COM port. Get into device manager. Yep, So finally it has successfully installed the required drivers, and under ports we can see MediaTek Linkit Smart 7688 Duo with COM port 5. So let's open up the Arduino, get into COM port 5, and let's just upload the blink sketch and let's see if it like able to blink the onboard LED that is again connected to pin number 13 only. So I'll just hit the upload button. Yep, after the sketch got uploaded, we can see the LED has started blinking. So you can pretty much change the codes, and according to this pin diagram, you can access all those pins connected to this Atmega 324. And pin numberings are according to this only. So I'll put a link to this pin diagram in the description down below. So guys, that's pretty much about it, like how to interact with the microcontroller that is present in the 7688 Duo module. And this is not the only way you can access the GPIOs or the Atmega controller that is present on the Duo module. You can even control or connect to the microcontroller from the microprocessor itself, that is the 7688. So that again uses the formatter protocol, and I'll cover up that thing in an upcoming video. So that's all for today guys, I hope you have enjoyed this video. If so, hit the thumbs up button, and if you have not subscribed yet, consider subscribing my channel for latest videos like this. So see you next time with my next video. Till then, goodbye.